Contrary to popular belief, the car's battery is not the only source of power for any of its electrical systems. The alternator is essential for starting the vehicle, charging the battery, and powering the air conditioning system. A malfunctioning alternator causes the battery to discharge rapidly, which can cause your car to stall. However, what could malfunction and prevent the alternator from charging the battery? Let's find out. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Worn brushes. An alternator that is worn out or damaged is the most frequent cause of a car that isn't charging the battery. If the voltage is within the charging range, you can check it with a multimeter on the car battery and gently tap it with a hammer while the engine is running. When you lightly tap the voltage with a hammer while the car is running and it returns to normal, the alternator's carbon brushes are worn out and need to be replaced. As an alternative, you could swap out the alternator for a new one. Damaged alternator. The alternator may occasionally have an electrical issue, and even if the voltage remains constant, it may sustain damage. Voltage regulators or damaged diodes are two more frequent causes. Generally speaking, replacing either of these calls for more advanced alternator knowledge. On older cars, it was more common to replace parts inside the alternator, such as the voltage regulator, the diode plate, or the carbon brushes. Since alternators are now fairly inexpensive, replacing the entire unit is typically less expensive than fixing an internal alternator issue. Faulty fuse. The large power cable of the alternator is frequently connected to a massive fuse. It is typically located in the fuse box located in the engine bay of your car and is typically an 80 amps fuse or greater. Fuses either wear out or burst from a power surge. The alternator will stop producing current at that point. The fix is to find the specific fuse that regulates the alternator in your car's handbook and replace it. Some cars may also have a second small fuse, usually a 15A to 20A fuse, for the alternator control. Broken serpentine belt. Upon closer inspection, the alternator is made up of a belt and pulley system that transforms mechanical energy into electrical energy. The alternator is driven by the serpentine belt. If it malfunctions, the alternator will cut off as soon as the pulley sustains damage or your belt wears out and breaks. This may also occur if the serpentine belt is not properly tightened. Although automatic tensioners are found in most cars, it is still advisable to check them twice. In the event that your older car has a manual tensioner, you may need to tighten the serpentine belt. Replacing the pulleys and serpentine belt is frequently quite simple and affordable. Wiring issues or connectors. Usually, an alternator with three or four wires attached to it is operating properly. One large main cable and two or three smaller ones are included. The alternator depends on each of these wires to operate, and if one breaks, you may not be able to charge. Make sure there is no corrosion on the large power cable connectors that connect the alternator to the vehicle battery. If there is a problem with any connection, the cable will typically become warm. Examine or gauge these cables using a multimeter. Keep in mind that testing wires that are partially broken or have a poor connection requires you to load them, so measuring them is not always accurate. One of these wires should normally be receiving 12 volts, and the other wire should be going to the dashboard's battery light. It does frequently go to the engine control unit if you have a third one. You will need a wiring diagram specific to your car model in order to measure this correctly. Damaged car battery. The car's battery and alternator cooperate well. An extremely damaged vehicle battery may not accept any voltage from the alternator at all. In this instance, the cause of your issue is the battery rather than the alternator. The car can theoretically run solely on the power from the alternator, but this can result in high voltage spikes and other odd symptoms. So it stands to reason that a malfunctioning car battery could also prevent the alternator from charging. Engine control module error. Modern electronics are being added to cars more and more. In this sense, the majority of the electrical components in the car are managed by the engine control unit. The alternator in modern cars is also controlled. Rarely, there may be a problem with the engine control module not managing the charging of the alternator. To find out if there's another damaged component preventing it from charging, use an OBD2 scanner to check for any trouble codes. Rarely, an actual malfunctioning engine control unit may exist. However, you should always rule out any other potential reasons. How to diagnose and fix. To make sure your alternator is operating properly, there are a few simple steps you can follow. While the engine is running, gently tap the alternator with a hammer. If the charging resumes normal, the carbon brushes inside the alternator are worn out and require replacement. Examine the large power cable leading to the alternator and the large 40 to 60 amp fuse that is typically located close to the battery. Examine the ground cable that connects the engine and body. Verify that the alternator is spinning in tandem with the engine by checking the serpentine belt. Examine the wires leading to the charging light and the tiny power supply. A multimeter can be used to measure it, but accurate results may require the use of a wiring diagram and some knowledge of automotive electronics. To make sure the voltage regulator and the diode assembly are undamaged, you can measure them. Certain alternators can be used in their place, but buying a new alternator these days usually costs the same. What you believe to be more worthwhile is up to you. Hope the information was helpful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.